हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू सीरीज़। आज की वीडियो में हम जानेंगे HTML और CSS के बारे में। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल कवर अप HTML एंड CSS, विच इज़ अ बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर वेब डेवलपमेंट। वी विल कवर अप HTML एंड CSS फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग टू एंड इफ़ यू फॉलो दिस वीडियो। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस वीडियो, इफ़ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल देन प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन टू गेट द लेटेस्ट नोटिफिकेशन। So in this video we will cover up all the basic tags that are used in HTML, HTML elements, attributes, how we can do formatting in HTML, meta tags, then we will study about comments, how we can add comments in the HTML code, how we can insert image in the HTML document, how we can insert image and table in the web page, different type of list, how we can embed the links, how to use the different colors and fonts to make the web page presentable. What is HTML? HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. HTML is must for students and working professionals who want to become web developer. So it is usually taught in schools so that the student should have the basic knowledge of web designing. Now why you should learn HTML and CSS? What are the advantages of HTML? It is used to create beautiful and stunning websites. इससे हम अपनी वेबसाइट को बेहतरीन और आकर्षक बना सकते हैं। द सेकेंड रीज़न इज़ दैट इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू बिकम अ वेब डिज़ाइनर, इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू स्टार्ट योर कैरियर एज अ वेब प्रोफेशनल वेब डिज़ाइनर, देन HTML एंड CSS आर मस्ट। नेक्स्ट फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द वेब, इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू ऑप्टिमाइज योर वेबसाइट, मेक चेंजेस, कस्टमाइज इट सो एज टू बूस्ट इट्स स्पीड एंड परफॉर्मेंस, देन यू शुड हैव अ गुड नॉलेज अबाउट HTML एंड CSS to yield the better results. Next reason is that after learning HTML and CSS, it becomes easy to learn other languages. Once you understand the basics of HTML and CSS, then the other relatable languages, technologies like JavaScript, PHP, AngularJS, Node.js are become easier to understand. Now we will understand the different applications of HTML and CSS. HTML and CSS are used for web development, which we have already discussed earlier. Then they are used for internet navigation. HTML provides different tags which are used to navigate from one page to another. For creating a responsive UI, HTML pages nowadays work well on all the platforms, mobile, tabs, desktop or laptops. So all the customers and the companies, clients wants that their website should be responsive. Next, HTML pages once loaded can be made available offline on the machine without any need for internet connection. Next, HTML is also used for game development. HTML has a support for rich experience and is useful for gaming development area as well. So before starting HTML, you should know the basic syntax for writing the HTML code. All the HTML documents must follow the basic syntax. So first of all we write HTML, then we write head. Head stands for the header tag. Then we write the title. Title of the document is displayed within the title tag. Then we can close the title tag, we can close the head tag, and after that we write the body tag. Now whatever you want to display on the web page or the website is enclosed within the body tag. You can add paragraphs, you can add image, list, table, form, whatever is present inside the body tag will be displayed on the web. In the last, we will close HTML tag. Now there are different type of tags used in HTML language. HTML is a markup language and make use of various tags to format the content. Tags are enclosed within the angle braces. So first we start the angle bracket, then we write the tag name, and then we close the angle bracket. For example, head, title, body, HTML, all these are the basic tags. Now basically there are two type of tag. One is the container tag and the other is the empty tag. Container tag requires a starting as well as the ending tag, whereas the empty tag does not require the ending tag. Now we will discuss the different type of tags one by one. First is heading tag. There are six level of headings, six type of headings which we use, ranging from H1 to H6. H1 tag, H2 tag, H3 tag, H4, H5 and H6 tag. H1 being the maximum size and H6 is the minimum. H1 is the most important heading and H6 is the least important heading. H2 to H6 can be used as a subheadings. Next is P tag. P tag stands for paragraph tag. P tags allows us to structure our text into different paragraphs. Each paragraph is enclosed within P tag. First we will start the P tag, then we will type whatever you want to display in the form of paragraph, and then we will close the P tag. If you want to write a new paragraph, then you have to use the P tag again. Each paragraph text should be in between the starting paragraph tag and closing paragraph tag. For example, you can see the following code. Next, what is comment? Comment is nothing but a piece of code which is ignored by any web browser. Comments help you to understand your code and it increases the code readability and efficiency. So it is basically for the understanding of the user. HTML comments are placed in between the following tag. So this indicates the comment. Next is the line break tag or break tag. BR tag is used to break the line. So the piece of text following the BR tag will start from the next line. If you want to place the text in the next line, if you want it to start from the next line, then the BR tag is used. This tag is an example of empty tag, so we do not need to close it. For example, here we have written you delivered your homework, and after homework we are using BR tag, and then we have written thanks, then again we have used BR tag. So the BR tag is used to break the text, to break the line, so it will be displayed on the next line. If we will not use the BR tag, then the text will be displayed in the same line. Next, we can align the text or the paragraph in either left, right, center or justified. There are four types of alignment tag. One is the left tag, right tag, center and justified. So the left tag is used to align the text. The text will start from the left direction, left side, and right tag is used to move the text in the right. You can use the center tag to put any content in the center of the page. Next is the HR tag. HR tag stands for horizontal ruler. It is used to insert a horizontal line to divide or separate the document sections. HR tag is an example of empty tag. So it does not require an ending tag. We do not need to close it. You can see the following example. Next is the table tag. If you want to create or insert any table inside the web page, then the table tag is used. Table tag is used to create a table as many rows and columns according to the requirement. Next, we can change the background color or the properties of table tag. For that, we will use the attribute. We can use BG color attribute to change the background color of the table or just one cell, or we can use the background attribute which is used to set the background image for the whole table or just one cell. So is tarike se hum table ki properties ko change kar sakte hain. Next we will study about list. If we want to present the document or text in the form of points, in the form of bullets, or in an ordered or unordered ways sequence, then we use the list. So the list may contain the UL tag, OL tag or DL tag. We can use the list tag in three ways. UL stands for unordered list. This will list the items using the plain bullets. OL tag. OL stands for ordered list. The list elements are arranged in a particular sequence. They are displayed in a particular order. So let us study them one by one. So first is unordered list. An unordered list is a collection of related items that do not have any special order or sequence. The list is created by using the UL tag. Also, we can add or change the attribute of the UL tag by typing UL type is equal to square, UL type is equal to disk, UL type is equal to circle. So in this way, we can change the type of unordered list. Next is ordered list. If you want to put your items in a numbered list, in a definite sequence or order, then we use the OL tag. We can change the type of ordered list by using the attribute. OL type is equal to 1, which is used for numerals, numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, till so on. Similarly, we can use the Roman numerals or alphabets or letters. We can change the type of the ordered list. Next is a definition list. A definition list is a list of terms and corresponding definitions. Definition list displays the elements in a definition form like in dictionary. Here we use the DL tag and DD tag. Next, we can also insert images in our document. For this, we use the IMG tag, that stands for image tag. To make our document attractive, we can beautify our web documents by adding graphics or images in it, audio clips, video clips. To insert the image, you have to specify the source. We use the tag IMG. IMG SRC is equal to, then we add the link from where we have taken the image. Whether we are inserting the image from our computer, laptop or PC, or we have taken the image from the internet, from any other website. So we will add the URL, we will insert the URL of the website. Also, you can change the properties of the image. You can set the image width and height based on your requirement using the width and the height attribute. For example, here we have taken width is equal to 150, height is equal to 100. So in this way, we can change the size of the image. Also, we can align the image in either direction, left, right or center, whichever way we want. I hope now you have understood and you are familiar with HTML tags. So you can design simple web page using HTML. Next, we will study about CSS. CSS stands for Cascade Style Sheet. CSS is a style sheet language which is used for describing the presentation of the document written in markup language like HTML. So it is basically used for designing and presenting the document in a beautiful manner or way. What are the advantages of CSS and why you should learn CSS? So, CSS saves our time. CSS is used to add styling element to the web page or document. It is used to create stunning websites. Less code means that the page gets loaded faster. It is easy to maintain. We can simply change the style and all the elements in all the web pages, which will be updated automatically. CSS has a wider array of attributes than HTML, so you can give a far better look to your HTML page in comparison to HTML attributes. It has multiple device compatibility. By using the same HTML document, different version of the website can be presented, which can run on mobile phone or any device like laptop, computer, desktop. So in this video, it will not be possible to discuss CSS in detail as there are many attributes and properties of CSS. Basically, there are three types of CSS which we will discuss one by one. First is the inline CSS, second is the internal or embedded CSS, third is the external CSS. Inline CSS contains CSS property in the body section. So inside the body tag, we use this CSS element. This kind of style is specified within the HTML tag using the style attribute. You can see the following example. Next is the internal or embedded CSS. internal or embedded CSS requires you to add the style tag in the head section. Yes, please notice we insert the CSS tag inside the head section of your HTML document. Also, we use internal CSS for single page. It is an effective method of styling a single page. But for multiple pages, we generally do not use internal CSS. You can see the following example. Here we have used the internal CSS inside the head section, inside the head tag of HTML document. Next is the external CSS. In external CSS, you can change the look of the entire website by changing just one file. So basically what we are doing is that we are adding the CSS file to our HTML document. You basically have to mention or add the CSS file link. So here the link tag is used to link the external style sheet with the HTML web page, and href attribute is used to specify the location of the external style sheet. I hope you like this video. Do write in the comment section if you have any doubt. So in coming days, we will cover up the entire course. We will study JavaScript, PHP. We'll create simple project using HTML and JavaScript. So do subscribe this channel to get the latest notifications. Thanks for watching this video. Meet you next time.